Hey friends, welcome. Today we are going to discuss the entropy production due to heat flow, or basically the entropy expression for entropy production for an irreversible thermodynamic process. So basically the topics that we are going to discuss in irreversible thermodynamics from now onwards, they are taken from, or I have taken from, Principles of Physical Chemistry by Puri Sharma and Pathania. So we have already studied the first law of thermodynamics, that is basically the law of conservation of energy, and it says that energy can neither be produced nor be destroyed. Also, but the entropy is a property which is not a conserved quantity, and entropy change can take place. So for any natural or spontaneous process, always there is an increase in the entropy. So for any natural process or any process that is taking place spontaneously, the entropy of that particular system will increase, and thus we may say that for such a spontaneous process there is the production of the entropy, or we may say that the entropy is produced in such a process. And over here the entropy is basically, it is an extensive property, that means it will depend on the bulk of the system which we are taking. We consider that a particular system is divided into very small amount of sections, then the total entropy will be the sum of the entropies of all these sections. Let's say suppose entropy of this particular section is ds1, this is ds2, and so on. So the entropy, total entropy ds, will be the sum of ds1, ds2, and so on. So it will be equal to all the entropies. So thus over here, in order to simplify this particular thing, we may split our entropy into two parts. So first is the first entropy, that we may denote it as DES, which is the entropy flow due to the interaction with the exterior, or due to the interaction with the surrounding. And the second is DIS, which is the entropy contribution due to the change in the inside of the system. So basically DES is the entropy wherein the entropy change when our system is interacting with the surrounding, and that entropy change is referred as DES, and DIS is the internal change in the entropy. So let me explain you by taking an example. That is, suppose we are performing any particular chemical reaction. Say in an RBF, you have taken the reactant A and B, and you are supplying certain amount of heat. So the flow of heat, from the burner, or the flow of entropy due to the interaction between the burner and the container, or the heat generated, will be our DES. And when the chemicals, that is the entities A and B, they react to give any product, then at that time also there would be certain amount of entropy change. So that is our DIS. So because of the internal, or when the entropy is changing because of the internal contribution, then, or because of the inside of the system, then it will be DIS. And when there is an external interaction, or when entropy is changing due to the interaction with the exterior of the system or with the surrounding, then it is DIS. And the total entropy, that is DS, we may write it as DES plus DIS. Okay, and over here DIS is equal to zero for a reversible process, and always DIS is greater than zero for an irreversible process. So always when DIS should be greater than zero for an irreversible process that we are looking at. And further, this quantity can never be a negative one. So DIS can never be negative one, and this DIS is our entropy production, because this is the entropy which is produced. Now suppose if we consider that our system is made up of two phases, that is phase 1 and 2, which is maintained at two different temperatures, that is phase 1 is maintained at temperature T1 and phase 2 is maintained at temperature T2, and we have already studied the second law of thermodynamics, which says that dS is equal to, we have dQ upon T, where dQ is the heat received from the surrounding and T is the temperature of the system, and always as told dS will be positive. Now for this particular system, when our system is divided into two phases, okay, as you have earlier also seen that when our system is divided into small number of phases, then the total entropy dS will be equal to dS1 plus dS2. And as entropy is split, also the heat received, that is dQ, will also be split into the two quantities, that is heat received, that is we can write this as D1Q, that I can write it as D1EQ plus DI1Q. So this is our heat because of the external interaction, and this is the internal generation because the reaction may be exothermic or an endothermic reaction, so there may be the heat change. So similarly for the second system, that is D2Q, we can write it as DE2Q plus D2IQ. Okay, further we may substitute these terms in this particular expression. That means we can write D1S is equal to D1Q upon T1, and that we can write it as DEIQ upon T1 plus DI1Q upon T1, and similarly for the second case, that is that will be D2Q upon T2, that is equal to DE2Q upon T2 plus DE2Q upon T2. Okay, so these are the two cases, and when we combine this, that is we have written that our total entropy dS is equal to this, so values of this can be substituted over here and this also can be substituted over here, and hence our expression and will be equal to, we can write dS that is equal to D1EQ upon T1 plus D2EQ upon T2 plus DITI1Q into 1 upon TI minus 1 upon T2. Okay, so over here from both this we can take, because the heat, the internal heat for the system will be same, that is as we have taken two components, so over here also suppose we can consider two components A and B, so the internal heat for both the components will be same. So over here in place of D2IQ I will substitute only D1, and hence everything remains same. Okay, now over here in this expression, the first two terms, it represents our dES, and this term it represents dIS, which is our entropy production arising due to the transfer of heat from phase 1 to phase 2. Okay, and this is our, and this transfer of heat basically arises from phase 1 to phase 2 as because of the temperature difference. Okay, and hence this we can write it as dIS that is equal to DI1Q into 1 upon TI minus 1 upon T2. And over here in this expression we can see that if T2 is greater than T1, then and then dIS will be greater than 0, and in that case dIS will be greater than 0, since this quantity is always greater than 0. Okay, and even if we have T1 is greater than T2, then under such circumstances also DIS will be greater than 0, because under such circumstances the value of DIQ will be less than 0, and as a result the whole system or our value of DIS will always be greater than 0, as we have seen earlier. Further, the value of DIS will only be equal to 0 when our system is under thermal equilibrium, that is when T1 is equal to T2. At that time DIS will be equal to 0, and under such circumstances our system will be a reversible system, and that we are not very much interested. Okay, so hence this expression can be written in the form, that is sigma. So we are representing the entropy production in the form of sigma, and hence we are writing sigma is equal to, we may write it as, generally the entropy production is written in the form of entropy production per unit time, and hence the entropy production per unit time we may write it as dIs upon dt, and that will be equal to dI1Q upon dt into 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2. Okay, so this is the expression for the entropy production, and this expression we can see that it is our entropy production, that is sigma, and in also in many books the expression is written as sigma V, wherein sigma V, it refers to the entropy production per unit volume. Entropy production per unit volume, the entropy production, it is made up of two terms. One is this one, and another is the temperature term. So the first term, that is the rate of heat transfer, that is, as I told, this is the rate of heat transfer, and this is the difference of the state function, or our temperature difference. Okay, and this one, that is DIQ upon DT, it can be considered as the microscopic cause, or this is the driving force for the heat transfer, and which is considered as the flux. So over here, as we have seen earlier also, that for an irreversible function, we have written it as J is equal to L into X, where L was the constant and thermodynamic quantity was proportional to the driving force X. And also over here, the entropy production, we have the driving force, or we may say it as a flux or flow, because of which there is an entropy production. Okay, hope this topic is clear. Thank you very much.